Welcome to this week's episode of Crushed, the show where we talk about your favorite teen heartthrobs from the 90s and 2000s. This week's crush is Thora Birch.
Tina, tell us how you felt at the exact moment you realized you had won.
Well, Rona, I can only say that I've thought about this day. Dreamed about this day for as long as I can remember.
Before we get into this one, please remember to like, save, and share this video to let this infernal app know, to show it to other people and help indoctrinate them into the cult of Megs. And that's right, there has been a name change. Don't know if you've noticed. Also, these are micro-documentaries, and Thora has over 60 credits to her name, so if I don't cover one of your favorite projects, please feel free to mention it in the comments in a friendly and respectful way. Thanks. Thora Birch was born on March 11, 1982 in Los Angeles, California. And no, I had no idea that we shared a birthday until I started researching this, so how serendipitous is that? Happy birthday, Thora. Her parents, Jack and Carol, had originally picked the name Thor for their impending baby, but feminized it when Thora appeared. She also has a younger brother named Bolt. Thora started acting at the age of 4, appearing in commercials for brands like the California Raisins, remember them? And Burger King. Her acting career took off rather quickly, appearing in The Purple People Eater in 1988 with Shelley Winters and Neil Patrick Harris, before landing a reoccurring role on the show Day by Day, which ended after 2 seasons. Thora continued appearing in one-off episodes of shows like Doogie Howser, MD, before landing another reoccurring role on Parenthood with Ed Begley Jr., David Arquette, and Leonardo DiCaprio. The same year that Parenthood wrapped, Thora appeared in the iconic holiday movie All I Want for Christmas as Hallie O'Fallon, little sister to Ethan, played by our favorite Ethan, Ethan Embry. She then appeared in Patriot Games alongside Harrison Ford. Thora loved Indiana Jones and said that she was very nervous to work with Harrison Ford, but that he was great. Thora continued her reign as child actor supreme, appearing in 1993's Hocus Pocus. Hocus Pocus did initially flop in the box office, but became a cult classic a few years later, as it should have. Following year, she appeared in Monkey Trouble as Eva, a young girl who ends up with a pet monkey who's actually a pickpocket. We really did love a movie with an animal co-star in the 90s, didn't we? That same year, she reunited with her old buddy Harrison Ford in Clear and Present Danger alongside Willem Dafoe and Ann Archer. Then came the movie that defined a generation, Now and Then. Megan, roll that clip.
When you're 12, without effort, you live in the moment. You don't regret the past or worry about the future. And at that moment in the treehouse, Teenie filled my heart with hope and comfort.
Best friends for life. For life.
Thora played Teenie, a teenager much ahead of her time. Thora said that she looked forward to the role. It would be her second time working with a female director, it had an all-star cast, and she would be able to forge friendships with other girls, something she didn't usually get to do with being out of school for large chunks of time. The problem was that what she had wanted, she got. She was on set with a bunch of girls, but they weren't very nice to her. In 1996, she appeared in Alaska with Vincent Kartheiser, where they played siblings looking for their dad in the mountains, and she continued appearing in guest spots on shows like Touched by an Angel. And then came American Beauty. The 1999 Academy Award-winning film focused on Lester Burnham, played by Kevin Spacey, who was experiencing midlife crisis and became obsessed with his teenage daughter's best friend. Thora played his daughter, Jane. American Beauty was Thora's transition into more adult roles, and there were questions surrounding Thora's nude scene in the movie, given that she was only 16 at the time of filming. At the time, she said her parents gave her the go-ahead, encouraging her to do it as they felt it was an important part of the character development. In case you didn't know, Thora's parents are former corn stars who appeared in a very well-known film from the 70s.
It was Deep Throat.
Liberal in some cases, protective in others, I guess. Thora said that during that time, she felt like there were a lot of expectations being put upon her that she didn't necessarily agree with or even have for herself. After the immense commercial success of American Beauty, Thora went on to appear in low-budget indie films like The Smokers, before appearing in the 2001 cult classic Ghost World as Enid alongside Scarlett Johansson, Steve Buscemi, and Brad Renfro. And then she kind of disappeared from the mainstream. In an interview from 2014, the interviewer commented on her taking a step back, which Thora did not appreciate. It makes me angry when you use that phrase, because I didn't step back, I was always working, it's just that no one was paying attention. And she did do a string of TV movies and music video appearances, but didn't appear in anything with American Beauty's level of commercial success during that time. In 2009, she was in Deadline with Brittany Murphy, one of Brittany's last movie appearances before her death that year. Thora continued taking on roles in independent movies every few years, and in 2013, she attended Kaplan University as a pre-law student. A very different trajectory than her former co-stars Christina Ricci and Scarlett Johansson. And it wasn't that Thora couldn't have gone down the path that they did. She turned down roles in major films like Interview with a Vampire. It was that she'd become very disillusioned with Hollywood after all those years in the industry. Thora didn't fit the A-list sex symbol role that was expected of her once she hit 16. She didn't want to sit there with her mouth shut looking pretty, and it cost her roles, like 1999's Election when she was fired for not agreeing with the script. She saw her peers suffer from trying to fit in. When she worked with Brad on Ghost World, she saw how bad he was, saying that she was shattered by the state of him. When she worked with Brittany, she noted that there was something off about her condition. She saw how much Hollywood could give, but also take away. In 2010, she was set to appear in the off-Broadway revival of Dracula, but after one performance, she was fired after her dad allegedly threatened another actor. According to her father, who also acted as her manager, the actor kept rubbing Thora's back, and she didn't like it, so he asked the guy to stop. The actor perceived it as a threat, and Thora got the boot. By 2014, Thora was agentless and had huge gaps in her CV. But she kept pushing, and finally, by 2016, things started working in her favor again. She appeared on a few episodes of The Colony and landed the lead in 2018's The Competition alongside Chris Klein. That same year, she married talent manager Michael Benton Adler at San Francisco's City Hall after a three-year engagement. A year later, she scored a 9-episode arc on The Walking Dead, and in 2022 appeared in The Gabby Petito Story, the Lifetime movie covering the tragic events surrounding Gabby Petito's disappearance and ultimate end of life. Most recently, Thora appeared in Anne Rice's Mayfair Witches, fitting for Lil Danny from Hocus Pocus, and has two more projects in post-production.